Welcome back. Where's that little notepad? You took it away from me.
He asked for it back.
Yeah, I mean... thank you. I was wondering why you took it. And I'm going to remind everybody, we're at Quaker Steak Lube, Newport News. Great food. You want to face the deal, it's great.
You're Matt Mullen.
Matt Mullen. And I'm going to Stephen Durbin. I got Steve Anderson here.
You're learning.
That's good. I'll tell you a secret about that later.
Want to show your hands?
No, I'm very good. I'm going to thank our sponsor.
Steve?
Thank our sponsor, TC Doctor, Hampton, Virginia, on King Street. Visit the website, www.tcdoc.wf. Sponsor driver.com on the web. And get some help with sponsorship.
Yeah.
And thank you, too. See, you didn't write that down. If you don't write it down, I'll never see
it.
Well, that's true, too. You're allowed to have the big huge ones on there. Go to YouTube.
Well, I don't know about that, but
go to YouTube, check out our previous shows. You can still go to our website, letstalkracing.tv. YouTube platform. Well, you can still go to our website too, though, right? letstalkracing.tv. Archive shows are on there. Great shows in the past.
Oh, yeah.
We got to get Donnie Terry back on there.
It's not bad,
but... Yeah. It was a little bit. I'm talking about some of our stuff. We're done with that. Brian Tidball, I want to thank him for calling, coming up.
Oh, yeah.
VMS, and he's also, and I wanted to talk to him, he's on the board of executives for the late model, the dirt late model Hall of Fame of the Tennessee.
Oh, okay.
And I was getting lunch.
Yeah.
You know, so I didn't even get half myself. We could have kept Donnie Harris here. Yeah, Donnie and Terry, and some of the great stories that he's got. I just shared a couple with you. I got a few more. Girl Six driver, Steve Emerson. Yeah,
you just go sit down.
Stop it.
32, Middlesex, Virginia. Been racing off and on since I was 5 or 6 years old, and just started in 36 last year, and looking at DNF for a while with the series. Moving up to either a legend car or a late model.
Do you think moving up from a 36 to a legend, would you do that?
I'm just always going to legend car. We can have a little talk about that. Call on what you like.
Well, that's true. And legends are really good cars. They really are. I ran for a couple of years. They're a good business. Pro 6. Got some great sponsors coming up. Quaker Steak Lube has come on. We want to thank them again. This has been great.
They've helped me out a lot. Pizza Shop in Yorktown. Camco Paint and Norfolk. Stream Racing Products in Yorktown. And Cameron Walton out of Norfolk as well.
Yeah.
I've got any of them that I've been doing here to come off to do what I'm doing. So, they've helped me out a lot.
What's your goals for this year? I mean, you said, you know, this will actually be your first full year.
Right. In this class, and I'd like to be in the top five. I mean, I'm not setting my standards too high for what it was, but I like to run top five in the race. So, I think that's really good. Especially some of the changes we've made.
Big star back here. I ran 4 races back here?
I ran 4-point races and won the money race. You won the money race.
So you still got your rookie status.
Yeah.
And enjoying it. Too much guys to race for.
It really is. Everybody seems to get along for the most part. As you know, everybody's going to help everybody out if they need something. I mean, I came to your trailer many a time last year to get stagger tool or this or that and everything else. So you can't, it's not like that in a lot of the series you see out there.
Yeah.
A lot of people just, you know, you ain't got it, oh well, you're free.
Yeah.
But, can't complain about that. Everybody there is on the same level. Some good drivers out there, a lot of new drivers. There's some seasoned veterans out there, but for the most part, everybody helps everybody. Everybody tries to race between the possible. There ain't no drama going on. Like some of the grand stock races and stuff. Everybody's wanting to fight after the race.
Sometimes.
Yeah.
There were a couple left.
We won't talk about that.
Not between you and me.
No.
For the most part, I got along with everybody, but yeah,
I remember how you're right.
There's always an exception.
Yeah, there is some exceptions to the rule. Monte Carlo, right, this year. Nissan Motors, and if everybody doesn't know, they run a Nissan 3.0.
If you really want to get technical, we are closer to the size of an original Monte Carlo
than a late model.
Than a late model. Hey, if you really want to get technical about it. 05, 06.
I'm running 03.
03.
How far is it a little
like? Mine was an 05.
I'm running ARP body.
There you are, body.
I got a deal on the body, so I won't go to 03.
Isn't that a whole new body?
Everything's new except for one door in the roof. One door was still practically brand new from last year, and the roof is just no more change in the roof than having a damage. So,
yeah.
Put that money up on the tires or something.
Yeah.
But,
what did you think of it when you first got into it? What did you think of the car you first got today?
I liked it. Because, you know, we had a lot of problems with the handle of the car. And then, you know, we found out what our problems were with that. Hopefully this year we haven't got a test yet, but hopefully that's all worked out now for all the new stuff we put in it. So, but for the most part, I mean, I loved it. I had a blast. So, a couple things here and there that I would like to see done differently, but, you know, that's with anybody, I guess, in racing. Everybody's got their opinion how they want to see things done, but all you can do is voice your opinion and have somebody take it and listen to it.
Yeah.
But, and that's the only thing about the series is that the series is, I would say, one of the more open series where if you got a suggestion or something, you can talk to Shane, Bush, Bill, Warren, and they'll actually listen to what you have to say. Whereas a lot of times, they don't want to hear what you got to say. The rules are the rules, and if you got a way that can be done better, they'll actually listen to it and try to talk to you.
Right. Warren, and Warren Smigel's been really good at being the, how would you put it, the
director, if you will.
Director, as if you would. He's done a great job. He brought it along. We got some new cars coming out this year.
What I understand is we'll be close to 15 cars this year.
At the start of the year.
That's awesome.
So,
and a lot of these pretty good. People don't realize that, you know, I'll never really think racing, they spend tons of money. And for the money that you spend on the first 6 car to race all year long, if you actually divide it up, it's not very expensive at all.
Yeah.
Compared to some other hobbies. I mean,
yeah.
I've done go-karts, I've done dirt bikes, I've done jet skis, you know, I've done motorcycles, and by far this is the cheapest form of, you know, that's the sort of activity I've done. So, I mean, you can't really complain. So.
And there ain't nothing like being at a racetrack.
You can't beat that.
You can't beat that.
Even, I mean, you know, last year, the legend happened. Like, I won't race this year. I was there every day. I mean, it's, you know, I wanted to talk to a guy today and he asked me if I had any bad habits. I was like, yeah, racing. So, I mean, it's an addiction.
Yeah, it definitely is. And it's a lot of fun to do.
Oh, yeah. And it's good fun. I mean, it's like my son, I'm trying to get my son involved in it. Next time I put him in a great car. From the kids that I see, like, I know we talked about him a lot, Anthony Perez. He's a young kid, and he lives, breathes, and dies racing. That's all he cares about. And it's got a good size and a downfall. You know, you got to keep his regular living, but yet on the same hand, keep him out of trouble. Keep him wanting to do drugs. Keep him wanting to go out and cause trouble. I mean, they got something to look forward to. Every year they get to work on the car, every weekend they're racing. So,
yep.
I think you can see it's more of a family-friendly activity than a lot of other things are. So.
And it really is, and it brings the family, you know, it'll, you know, if you get the right
I hate to say it, but with the right people in the family, they really support it. And it's like, you know, Donnie was talking here, and his wife was big in it, his daughter, and his, you know, son, of course, Terry was big in it. That's what they did, and that's probably what, you know, kept them all out of trouble there for a while, I would say. And it's, you know, started from, like, for example, bowling or whatever. I mean, you go to the bowling alley, everybody's drinking and whatnot, not knowing what they're bowling alley. Well, yeah, because at the racetrack, yeah, the fans are drinking, but in the pit, no alcohol allowed, no drugs allowed, you know, nothing like that. It's a clean atmosphere for the kids to be around, and
still after the last day.
Yeah, right. And it builds a nice bond between, you know, most cases, similar to the father and son, to build, you know, that bond of working together and stuff like that. So, I mean, I'm looking forward to the long run right now.
Yeah.
So, at my point, so he's old enough for me, and he's old enough for them to go.
Big headline of the week.
I mean, I don't know. I wasn't
I'm not gonna say I was a Danica fan, but I kind of, when she first started, I always kind of, you know, rooted for her a little bit, just because I wanted to see her do something.
Something new.
It seems to me now, especially after seeing on here sometimes, some other female drivers, that she doesn't realize what she's been given, per se.
Says it's shutting down.
Okay.
Well, then why did you say it in front of us?
But Danica to me is just more like an advertiser.
Yeah.
You know, instead of, she doesn't, I mean, I don't want to talk bad about any driver, but she doesn't show the ability to even finish in the top 10 yet when they're ready. You know what I mean?
Yeah. She had the third place a couple weeks ago. Fourth place, sorry.
Bristol. Out of how many starts and how many...
Out of how many, yeah. Race. Actually,
there was no other start in Parkston.
I just feel like she's more of a marketing ploy
for right now. Well, for her marketing group, yeah, I can see what you're saying.
Yeah. In other words, if it was in your buses out there and running like she was running, we would have already been fired.
Well, I wouldn't say that.
No, I wouldn't say that. In that top-notch equipment, I can go out there and run for it. I would feel comfortable doing that. You know, is she a good driver? I believe so.
You can see she's got it in her.
Yeah, I think she's got her in her. Probably more so than
she's got a lot of it. I think she's scared, drunk.
You know,
a lot of being scared of
it. No, I don't think she's being scared. I think she's being cautious. I don't think she wants to get into something that she can't get herself back out of. Because I think next year she really wants to do this full time. I think that's what you're going to see her do. But she knows she's got to learn right now and gain respect.
And as a rookie, that's what you need to learn,
right,
too, is you need to gain that respect. And that is such a huge jump over from any car to a stock car. I've never, ever driven a stock car before. So that,
well,
has
yeah,
a lot to do with it, too. The heavier car.
It almost might be a step down, yeah. But you're right, it's a totally different
scenario,
you know.
Twice as much horsepower, you know.
Well,
probably
was half
as much.
Twice
as much.
Scott Nixon and Jim and Murray. They just drive through. They both pulling each other's car out.
Yeah.
One of them things, I mean.
Somebody else is doing that, too.
Sonny Stewart and,
F1 car, though.
Yeah, F1 car is Watson Glenn, I guess.
Mark Webber, or...
I think it's Mark Webber. It's one of the Red Bull guys.
One of the Red Bull guys.
Yeah.
I bet Tony does decent in it.
Oh, I'm sure
he did it a few years ago with my boy.
But Gordon never ran any car. Tony ran an Indy car before, so he did good in Indy car.
Yeah, he won a championship.
He won every race for that year. I remember that. I saw it in Charlotte.
So what do you think about the whole Denny Hamlin shootout? What's your opinion on that?
I think it'll be really good. There's more guys that are going to want to go to it.
What's new?
They're having it at Richmond International Raceway.
They're going to have it
on 28.
Okay.
I will plug that.
$25.
$25. You get the Denny Hamlin race and you get the K&M race. So you're going to have a lot of K&M drivers there. You're going to have a lot of Cup drivers. You know, indeed.
Thursday night,
Saturday night,
Nationwide.
Friday night, Nationwide, Saturday night, Cup. So I think it'll be a good thing. The late models have been there before. They know how to run there.
Most
of them. And I bet a lot of the guys, you know, like your CDs and your Nick Smiths and the guys that have never, your older guys are going to know how to run there, you know.
Yeah.
Your Bud Fairfield and, you know, guys like that. But I think it'll be a good thing. You'll see more Cup drivers want to do it this year. Because then they get time on the track.
They got Logano, Stewart, Denny, obviously.
Kevin Harvick. Marcus Ambrose, I believe, is going to do it again. Bobby Labonte, I think, is going to do it again. He did it last year. He had a blast. The fun thing I like about Bobby Labonte is Marcus Ambrose. Bobby didn't get in. The car broke. So he didn't get in. But he was standing there when they were all racing, and Marcus came in with a problem or something. Bobby acted like a crew member. He's over there working on the car, you know.
He's still getting those
like
Louis. Oh yeah.
And they all do, you know, they all have fun.
Tony Stewart, I believe, is going to do it again. So I've heard some other names that are thinking about doing it, but I wait until they say yeah, they're going to do it.
It should be a good race either way, though.
Yeah,
it'll be a really good race. I know Pinch's been feeling for a little high last year.
Did you go?
Nope. I actually had to work that night. I watched it on video. I had some of my video for me up there. And after watching that and hearing some of the stories I heard and everything like that, I'm going to make sure I'm there this year.
It's going to be.
The funny part about it is, Doc and I, we're standing on the back foot of Southside. And you know, Southside's not that big.
Okay,
a little bullring.
Hey, oh, yeah, just a tiny little bullring. But we're standing there. They got a red flag. It wasn't Chris Dawson's wreck, it was something was going on up at 1 and 2, they had cars parked on the other side, so they ran the flag and stopped and parked them up. You know what I'm talking about. Austin just said, the announcer goes, where's the air Camarola going? Here he comes running. We thought he was going after somebody on the back stretch. He might have been mad at the cars. Yeah, out of the cars. Jumped in the spot of had to go to the bathroom. Got out and the cog went nuts. He went, went back to his car, strapped in. He ran good that night.
He ended up running deep.
He's been getting better
every week. Late models have run up there before.
Yeah, 11 years ago.
10 years ago? 11 years ago?
And that's true. And they have some technology on the way.
Yeah, that's true too.
I might have an idea.
That's
pretty fancy.
They
get a lot of weight, but I don't have a friend that takes a lot of drive.
Yeah, they're going to have to know side in on it. Yeah.
So,
you know,
from what I understand, there's some people out here that are trying to get their attraction and all that. Yeah. So.
And I bet they'll start 36 this year. So when they start 24 out here?
24.
Oh, we got 50. We're going to run up there deep and 456. We got to put a quarter inch windshield in it. Imagine going down the front stretch at about 150 down in the Richmond and that front windshield would go boom. Yeah, I didn't do that. Darren Watson did that. Did you ever hear that story? Went to Talladega or something, they hooked up three posts in it. He only had two, and kept asking the guy. You ain't going out there without that post. Fuck Talladega. No way. Going back to the pit, put a piece of electrical tape in it.
Good? Okay.
Go on. Yeah. It's 10 o'clock. Let's get out of here. And we just had a great time.
Well, wait.
Yeah, just like I said,
throw it in there. Kyle Busch swept the weekend. Throw that in there.
Well, but when we go to a place like this, it's great to do a long
time. Maybe for an hour earlier.
Oh, hell no.
I won't get there in time.
If we do them at the office, we need to keep them an hour, hour and a half. We go out to some place like this, yeah, we need to go do it 2 hours. And I've never argued about that. Well, we did a 3 hour one tonight. Probably won't be the last.
Usually we go out, we can have a 3 hour one.
9:30 is usually when we get here. I think this is the first time we've gone to 10.
Yeah.
I think so, yeah.
Either we're picking
up. Thank you to Quaker. That's done. When we get up here, I want to say thank all my sponsors. Y'all can follow me on Facebook, SMMS and Motorsports. Thank you. Thanks for Quaker Steak Lube. Are we off the air?
No.
Thank you. Have a wonderful night.